Good morning, dear student. In my channel, once again, we are dealing with the animal diversity third. In this, we have already studied the characters of class Pisces, as it belongs from the group Gnathostomata, which is having 5 different classes: Pisces, amphibians, reptiles, snails, and mammals. Of which we are dealing with the Pisces, and we have already studied the general characters of class Pisces. Along with that, we have already studied the difference between cartilaginous fishes and bony fishes, that is the difference between chondrichthyes and osteichthyes fishes. Now, in today's lecture, we will going to discuss the classification of Pisces. In these classifications, we are going to study the different characters of the different classes and different groups of Pisces. So, before going to deal out the starts for today's topic, you are requested that please do subscribe my channel and press the bell icon for the update of latest videos. Now let's start the today's topic, class Pisces. As you know very well, the Pisces means, or the Pisces are nothing but the fishes. These fishes, which are broadly divided into two groups, one is chondrichthyes and another is osteichthyes. Chondrichthyes is cartilaginous fish and osteichthyes are the bony fishes. So first of all, we will see the chondrichthyes fishes. In these individual, body is spindle shaped, laterally compressed or dorsoventrally flattened and disc-like. The skin is tough, covered with minute placoid scales with mucous glands. Both median and paired fins are present and supported by horny fin rays. Caudal fin is heterocercal. Coelom is divided into anterior small pericardial cavity containing heart and a large peritoneal cavity containing viscera. Endoskeleton is entirely cartilaginous but no bone formation. Means the bones are absent. Instead of the bone, cartilage is present. Vertebrae are complete and separate. Notochord is persist but reduced. 5 to 7 pairs of gills are present for respiration. Gill slits are uncovered and without operculum. As we have already studied about this in distinguishing characters between chondrichthyes and osteichthyes. Ear bladder is absent. Heart is 2-chambered, that is 1 auricle and 1 ventricle. Hepatic and renal portal systems are present. Then stomach is J-shaped. Intestine is a short with a spiral wall. Brain is large. Olfactory lobes and cerebellum is large. 10 pairs of cranial nerves, well-developed sense organ. Cranial nerves are 10 pairs. Kidneys are mesonephric. Large amount of urea is retained in the body. Sexes are separate. Paired gonads are present. Internal fertilization is carried out. Some are oviparous or oviviparous, while some are viviparous. And this kinds of the placenta is present for the nourishment of the embryo. Most of the chondrichthyes are marine, some are freshwater and are predaceous, means they kill the prey and feed on it. And examples are Scolodon, Pristis, Praja. So these are the examples. And these chondrichthyes is subdivided into subclass Psyllaceae or Elasmobranchi. So let's see this subclass Psyllaceae or Elasmobranchi. Subclass Psyllaceae or Elasmobranchi, in which the body laterally compressed or dorsoventrally flattened. Exoskeleton is of placoid scales. Placoid scales, as I have already told you about in the distinguishing characters between chondrichthyes and osteichthyes species. And I will give the link in description box. You can better again see this video for again distinguishing characters. Again, in Psyllaceae or Elasmobranchi, upper jaw is not fused with the cranium. Its suspension, beak, hyostylic or amphistylic in nature. Teeth numerous and are modified placoid scales, means made from placoid scales. Spiracles may be present. There are 5 to 7 pairs of gills, and again without operculum, means protective covering is absent. Cloaca is present. Claspers present in male, associated with pelvic fin, and this is sexual dimorphic character. They are mostly marine and include sharks, dogfishes, rays and skates. The subclass Psyllaceae is divided into two orders, and these are, one is Pleurotremata and the second is Hypotremata. In the Pleurotremata, body is spindle shape, 5 to 7 pairs of lateral gill slits are present. Anterior margin of pectoral fin is free from the body. Most of them have 2 dorsal fins. Teeth are sharp and conical. They are predaceous, active swimmers, and the examples are Heptranchians, Scolodon, Spirna. Then the second order is Hypotremata, in which body is dorsoventrally flat. In these individual gill slits 5 pair, but ventral in position, because the body is dorsoventrally flat. Pectoral fin large, joins sides of the body to head. Tail slender and sharply marked off from trunk. Teeth blunt, spiracles are dorsal. They are bottom feeders. Examples: Raja, Torpedo, Pristis, Trigon. So this kinds of the electric fish also comes under this Hypotremata. Then second subclass Holocephali. It includes the individuals of their body, including this head is laterally compressed. Scales are absent. In adult, upper jaw is fused with cranium, forming holostyle suspension. Teeth are fused to form plates. Spiracles absent. Tail is slender and whip-like. only 4 pairs of gills are present, and gill slits are covered by a flap of skin, the operculum. Then vertebrae are poorly developed, cloaca is absent. Additional claspers are present on the head and belly. They are exclusively marine. There is a single order, that is Chimaera formis. Chimaera, which is a ratfish. So this is all about this cartilaginous fish. Now afterwards we'll move to the next major group, ostrichthyes or bony fishes. These are the most successful of all aquatic forms. In these individual, body is a spindle shape and laterally compressed. Both median and paired fins are present and supported by cartilaginous or bony fin rays. Caudal fin usually homocercal, single dorsal fin. Body covered by either ganoid or cycloid or ctenoid scales. And we have already studied the type of scales. Skin has many mucous glands in epidermis and scales embedded in dermis. Endoskeleton is partly or wholly bony vertebrae, and many notochord often persist in greatly reduced form. Pelvic girdle is often absent. Mouth is usually terminal with numerous teeth. Jaws are well developed and articulated to the skull. Jaw suspension is autostylic. Cloaca is absent, but anus is present. 4 pairs of gills are present, covered by operculum. Spiracles are generally absent. An air bladder is generally present, which is respiratory in low form but become hydrostatic in higher form. Heart is two-chambered. Brain has a small olfactory lobe and small cerebellum, 10 pairs of cranial nerve. Then sexes are separate. Paired gonads are present. Fertilization is external. Most forms are oviparous. Some are ovoviviparous or even viviparous. And I already told you about this oviparous, then viviparous and ovoviviparous. Egg laying are called as oviparous. Those give direct birth are called as viviparous. And those lay the eggs, in which the eggs hatch within the body and young one emerges out, this is called as ovoviviparous. And the examples are Accipienser, Amaya, Angula, Hippocampus, Exocetus. And this class Ostrichthyes is divided into two subclasses, which are this kinds of the this subclass Actinopterygii. Which includes these kinds of the bony fishes, and we'll see the characters of Actinopterygii. They are called ray finned fishes because Their paired fins have fleshy basal lobe. They are supported by radiating dermal rays. Dorsal fin is a single with spine. They have paired of external nares leading into nasal pits. Ear bladder serves as a hydrostatic organ. Operculum covers the gill of each side. Jaw suspension is hyostylic. And this subclass Actinopterygii is divided into three infraclasses. Infraclass 1, this Chondrosteidae. They are called primitive ray finned fishes and most of them have become extinct. Scales are ganoid, jaws are toothless. Paired fins have a broad base attachment. Tail fin is heterocercal. Ear bladder functions as a lung and has a duct leading to the pharynx. Intestine has a spiral wall, and there are again two order of this Chondrosteidae. These are number first order polypteriformis, in which dorsal fin is split into numerous finlets. Example, Polypterus. It is also called as Bichir. And the second order Accipensoriformis, in which body is snake-like and bears rows of heavy bony scales, and example is Accipiensis. Then the infraclass second, Holosteidae. They are called intermediate ray finned fishes, ancient and most of which are extinct. They are having the ganoid or cycloid scales, tail hemiheterocercal, skeleton is moderately ossified, that is bony, notochord generally persistent. Ear bladder is a single and spiracle is absent. This infraclass is divided into two orders, Semionotiformis, in which the snout is elongated. And example is Lepiosteus, that is gar picker. And order second, Amiformis, in which the snout is rounded and dorsal fin is very long. And example is Amaya. Then infraclass third, Teleosteidae. They are advanced ray fin fishes. Scales are cycloid or tinoid. Mouth is small. Tail fin is homocercal. Paired fins have narrow base attachment. Spiracle is absent. Skeleton is fully ossified, that is bony. Single ear bladder and hydrostatic in function. Four pair of gill covered by operculum. Teleosteidae is divided into 30 orders, of which only some important orders are taken here for consideration, which include this Anguilliformis. They are a snake-like body without scales and pelvic fin. An example is Angula, that is eel fish. Second order is Siluriformis, in which the head bears long sensory barbels and scales are absent. An example is Wallaroo, that is catfish. Or again one is Rita. Then the third order is Cypriniformis, in which body has a cycloid scales, fins without spines. Example is Libio and Cyprinus. Order number 4, that is Castrosteiformis, in which mouth is small at the end of snout, trunk is invested in bony armor, and the examples are hippocampus, that is a seahorse, and cygnathus, that is a pipefish. Then the fifth order is Atheriniformes, in which cycloid scales, these fins, soft side and spineless. Pelvic fins are abdominal. An example is Exocetus, that is flying fish. Then order sixth, Perciformes, which includes the anabas, climbing perch, and ignes, that is suckerfish, in which fin rays are hard and spiny and scales with serrated edge. Order 7, Tetradontiformes, in which body short, covered with the spines, mouth with the heavy teeth. Then these fins are spiny, pelvic fins are small or absent, and example is Diodon, Tetradon, and Ostracteon. Then the eighth order is Lophiformes, which include the flat square body with huge head and wide mouth. The first ring of the spiny dorsal fin is stripped with a fleshy flap to lure the prey. An example is Lophius, that is angler fish. Order 9, that is Pleuronectiformes, in which body is highly compressed and both eye on one side, bottom dweller individual. Example is Salia, that is soulfish. And order 10th is Cheniformes, in which extra lung-like respiratory organ, hence able to live outside the water for long time. Example, Ophiocephalus, that is Channa. Then subclass Sarcopterygii. They are commonly called lobe fin fishes. Paired fins have narrow base articulated with girdles. Lobe is fringed with dermal rays. Single or double lung is present. They are air breathing fishes. Tail fin is diphyseal. This subclass is divided into two orders, and the first order is Crossopterygii, in which fins are lobed, separate median fins are present, tail is three-lobed, cartilaginous skeleton, air bladder is reduced and act as a hydrostatic organ. Intestine has a spiral wall, spiracles are present, most of them are extinct. Example is Latimaria, that is coelacanth. Then second order is Dipnoi. They are commonly called lung fishes. Most of them are extinct, some are living form. They breathe by gill and also by an ear bladder. Body is long, slender, covered by overlapping cycloid bony scales. Paired fins are lobe or filament like and have basidial plan, that is have an elongated jointed axis extending out from the body and having pre and post axial jointed rays. Dorsal and ventral fins are confluent with the caudal fin. Then cranium primarily with lateral ossification. Jaw suspension is autostylic. Intestine has a spiral wall. gills are reduced, spiracle is absent. Ear bladder form a highly developed single or double lung. Dipnoi resemble amphibians in many features but are not their ancestors. Larva may have sucker and external gills. This order is divided into two suborders. Suborder first, Mononemona, in which single lung is present. An example is Neoceratodus. Suborder second, Dinemona, in which the individual has the double lung. Example is Lepidosirian and Proteopteus. And these are the representative examples of cartilaginous fish and bony fish, where we are just observing the scales which are present in bony fish, and very minute small microscopic placoid scales are present in cartilaginous fish. So these are the characters with the different kinds of the subclasses and orders of class Pisces. Hope you understand all these characters very well, and still having any doubt, please write it to me. And thank you very much for watching the entire video. So we'll see after this kinds of the classification, we'll see this different types of caudal fin. Thank you very much.